Thank you for joining us today. I'm Rudy Stebby, and welcome to Episode 11, Upgrading Windows XP to Windows 7, Part 1, here on HelpDeskTV. While Windows Vista allows you to perform an in-place upgrade to Windows 7, Windows XP does not. So you'll need to use a built-in utility on the Windows 7 DVD disk called Windows Easy Transfer to transfer your documents and settings from your XP-based PC to a backup location first. Please note that Windows Easy Transfer does not back up your applications, so you will need to reinstall those manually after you've installed Windows 7. After you've completed the backup on your Windows XP machine, you perform a clean install of Windows 7 on the PC and then use Windows Easy Transfer again to transfer everything back. In this part one of the series, we will go through the steps on how to back up your documents and settings. Here's how it all works. On your Windows XP machine, insert your Windows 7 setup DVD disk and cancel any auto-run window that may appear. Then, open My Computer and right-click on the Windows 7 Setup DVD drive and choose Open. Then, navigate to the directory Support MigWiz and then double-click on migsetup.exe. The Windows Easy Transfer utility will now start up. Click Next, and Windows Easy Transfer will now ask you how you want to transfer your items to your new computer. Here, you will have the options to choose between an easy transfer cable, transferring your files to a network drive, or what we will use in this case, a USB-attached external storage device. Click this option to move on. Windows Easy Transfer now asks if this is your old computer, so go ahead and select this option. Windows Easy Transfer now scans the user accounts on your PC for data to back up. When the scanning process is complete, the wizard will show you how much space the data from each user account will take up. You can click the Customize link under each account to customize what will be backed up. For additional customization, click the Advanced link at the bottom of the pop-up window. An Explorer-like window will pop up, allowing you to individually select or deselect content that will be backed up. When you're done, click Save, and then Next to move on. You are now prompted to provide a password for the Easy Transfer file that will be created. This step is not optional, so make sure you remember the password in this step, or you'll have to start the process all over again. Once you've entered your password, click Save to continue. You are now prompted to save your Easy Transfer file. A USB-attached external storage device is the ideal solution for this step. In this example, we have a USB drive located at drive E. Select the drive of your choice, click Open, and then click Save. Windows Easy Transfer now begins to save your files and settings. Click Next when the backup process completes to have a confirmation window display after the file transfer process. Click Next again, and finally close when ready. Once this process is complete, it would be advisable to use whatever backup utility you have to back up your entire Windows XP PC. This backup would not allow you to restore your XP machine if all goes awry, but would provide you with access to some critical data that the Easy Transfer Wizard may have missed. Now it's time to perform a clean install of Windows 7 on your Windows XP based PC. Place your Windows 7 setup DVD into your DVD drive if it's not already there, and reboot your PC. follow the instructions on the accompanying screens to complete the install of Windows 7. On a later how-to, we will document how to perform a clean Windows 7 install. In part 2 of this series, we will begin the process of restoring your documents and settings files that were backed up from your Windows XP system. I hope you enjoyed today's Help Desk TV. If you have a comment about this program, a question, or a shortcut you would like to share with me, send us an email message to feedback@helpdesktv.ca. Thanks for watching.